shall be exalted on high. For the Lord's house shall be exalted. For the Lord's house shall be exalted. Shall flow to it, and the people shall come and say, yes, the nation shall flow to it, and the people shall come and say, for the nation shall flow to it, and the people shall come and say. And the
even more. And so we invite you, Holy Spirit, we invite you to come and dwell, to come and dwell, to come and flood the atmosphere with your presence, to flood the atmosphere with that fresh anointing. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We invite your presence, oh God, to take preeminence over everything that we are about to do tonight, oh God. Take glory, take glory, take glory. You are welcome, you are welcome, Holy Spirit.
You are welcome here. Come flood I've tasted and seen
of the sweetest
of love. When my heart becomes free
and my shame,
and my shame is undone,
your presence,
Lord,
Holy Spirit,
Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere.
Your glory,
God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence,
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere.
Your
glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your
of the sweetest of loves. When my heart becomes free
and my shame,
and my shame is undone,
your
presence, Lord,
I've tasted.
I've tasted and of the sweetest of loves. When my heart becomes free
and my shame,
and my shame is undone,
your presence,
your presence.
So set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, I can't control. So I want more of you, God. So I want more of you, God.
Set a fire.
Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God.
We need more.
I want more of you, God.
Set a fire.
Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God.
I need more.
I want more of you,
set a fire.
So set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. Rather be than here in your
You feel
Jesus, you love us so much. Excess love. Love unconditioned. We bless you tonight. Good night, church. And good night to the viewers online. Our cry tonight should be, let us become more aware of the presence of God. Without God's presence in our lives, we are most miserable. Tonight, I want to talk about a little about the secret place of the Most High God. Psalms 91, the first verse said, "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty." Father, tonight we bless your name. And we give you praise and thanks, O God, that we will truly become more aware of your presence. Father and God, we declare that your word will go and touch lives, that life will be transformed. We declare over our life that everything that will be done here tonight will be done in faith. Father, we thank you because we know that you are forever present, the omnipresent God. We bless your name tonight. Hallelujah. There are certain things. I have six things here that we should know about the secret place of the Most High God. The first thing is the security of the godly. It is a journey of faith and intimacy. The secret place requires faith and the very closeness of God. Number two. It's more a spiritual location than a geographical one. So, it is not at a place. It is in a place with God. Three, it is a place that is invisible, yet accessible. It could be accessed anywhere. You can access this place anywhere you are. But not anyhow. It can only be accessed by faith and a receptive heart. That's a heart that obey the instructions of God. A heart of obedience. Another thing about the secret place. It is the heart of God where we experience his manifest presence. Because I can come in here like how I came in earlier. And I can experience the presence of God from someone else that is enthroned with the Spirit of God. I can experience that presence. But the presence that we want to experience is the manifest presence where God and us commune, where we reveal his secrets. That's the very relationship we seek with God tonight. There are three characters that I will be using tonight. The first character is David, the very person that wrote the 91 Psalms. The psalmist expressed his trust that God is a source of safety. He said, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. God, you see, when we come to a place in our God that our seek is the very God, very present. When our seek is that secret place, we guarantee that we are protected. That we will be protected. You see, sometimes when the storms of life, or we are faced with the storms of life, as we go through this life journey, our attitude should be one of confidence. But so often, when we are faced with trials, when we are faced with tribulation, when we are faced with persecution, when we are faced with all kind of, what I must say, situations, when we are faced with trials, temptation, the thing is, when we come to know this God, he never have us to be ignorant about the things that we will face in this life. We came preloaded that whatever that we will face in our life journey, the God that we serve is well able to protect us. But sometimes when we are faced with these things, we tend to doubt the word of God. We tend to doubt him. We tend to disbelieve what he says. When the storms are raging, when all these things rise up against us, we tend to forget what God has said. But David, a man of God's own heart, he stand confident in the things of God. David said, the sea will roar. You ever heard a sea roar? That's an abnormal sound. Well, he was trying to say how trying it could be. He said, the earth will shake, but he will remain confident in God. David said those things from an experience with God. Those trials and testings in our life, it should make us stronger. It should make us more confident in the things of God, in our walk. It should. David said, it said in Psalms 91:7. Feed from verse 5. Bear with me. He said, he shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shall thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. David said, 1,000 shall fall at thy right side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. That is the security when we find that secret place in God. Things will happen around us, but it will not come nigh us, because God is our shield. God is our buckler. He is our very source. He's our very protector in the times of storms. But tonight, truly, we have to rise in the things of God. It's too often. We try, when God speaks, we try to think. Is it God? Is it not God? You know, we try to come up with all kind of reasons. But David, as our perfect example here, guaranteeing us in the secret place of God, there is safety. So our sick tonight should be the secret place. You know, if we really and truly find that secret place, our very part will be so easy. We will have this smooth transition. Hallelujah. The second character I want to deal with is Abraham. Abraham, a man of faith, a man that walked with God, a man that communed with God, a man that trusted God, a man that obeyed God. When Abraham was called, when Abraham was called from his father's house, and I believe every one of us here know that story, Abraham didn't have a clue where we would have ended up. All of us knew that Abraham, his background was idol worship. That's what he knew all his life. And when God called Abraham, Abraham stepped out by faith. And he obeyed God, not knowing where he would have ended up. God required that same attitude from us. God looked forward for an unfeigned faith. A faith, when the storms is raging, we still stand confident. A faith Oh, God. I'm talking to me. Don't worry. Oh, Father. A faith when everything's come crashing. We still believe, God. We still believe, God. We still believe God. It doesn't matter what will come our way. We still believe Him. We still stand firm in faith. Oh God. Abraham. In Hebrews 11:17. It talk about when the same Abraham was tried, and he had to offer up his only son, Isaac. Abraham obeyed God. He obeyed God. And because of his obedience, and because of his faith in God, God let Abraham into that secret place. The secret place of the Most High God. In Genesis 18:17, God said, "Can I hide the secret from Abraham? Or should I hide the secret from Abraham?" It may not be in this word, but that's what it meant. He said, knowing that he will be a father of many nations. Knowing in him that his descendants will be blessed. You see, in the secret place, in God, you become a trusted vessel. God trusted Abraham. He trusted him to carry out the very purposes and the will and the plan of God. And Abraham was successful. When God looks at us tonight, can we be branded as this trusted vessel? That when he has given us instructions that we carried out to the last letter, can God say that about us? Tonight, church, for us to truly advance in the things of God, it required that faith and the obedience in God. When God said, move, you move. If he says, stand tall, stay right there. It takes self-discipline. That is another benefit in the very secret place of God, of the Most High. When we're able to discipline the very self that does not work in accordance to the will and the principle of God. There is a self that wants to rival God. But we have to come to a place as we go through this life journey, the disciplined self, and truly obey the voice of God. You know, God always speaks. The thing is, We will not know everything individually. Because the word said, we know in parts. We prophesy in parts. And the reason we know in parts is because God revealed to us what he wants us to reveal. But when we come as a unit, it becomes a whole. So our thing is, we have to be so sensitive to the voice of God. Abraham's background was idol worship. The other thing, he didn't know where he was going. But his heart was receptive to receive God. Tonight, let that be our seek. The secret place of the Most High God. And then we come to the last one. Paul. Paul, and everybody know about Paul, was Saul before Paul, when he was persecuting the church. But one encounter with the Spirit of God, just one encounter. The secret place provides transformation, transformative powers, transformative powers. The secret place provides that. One encounter with God, he was transformed and his name changed to Paul. And Paul lived a transformed life in the secret place of God. He went about doing God's business. He went about doing the very instruction God instructed him to. Tonight, there is transformative power in the secret place of God, that we can become more like Jesus, where we will portray all his attributes, all his characteristics, where we will live a life that pleases God. Tonight we must seek that place. That place where God live, where God dwells. We must make that secret place our abiding place, our permanent place, not intervals. One time we are in to hear what God has to say, and the next time we're not interested but what he has to say. We should develop that fear for God. That fear that will bring him reverence. We should develop that fear. That fear that will honor him. That fear that will do God's bidding. We should honor him. We should have that fear. That when life storms meet us. Because the word said, any man decide to live right, they will suffer these things. Our life wouldn't be void of these things. But we have a place where we can hide, where we can be protected from the darts, from anything that the enemy will throw. We will be protected. There is a psalm said, Psalms 31:20. It said, and when I read the psalms, I tell you, it shocked me. When the psalmist said, thou shalt hide them in the secret of his presence. I'm saying the secret place is the presence of God. And then David said, you will hide them in the secret of your presence. He said, from the pride of men, thou shalt keep them secretly in a pavilion from the strife of tongues. And I said, in the secret of your presence, Jen, talk after me, whole night. And I just locked the book, I went to bed. Woke up the next morning, in the secret of your presence, and his response, we will be hid in the heart of God. When we are hid in the heart of God, there is nothing or no one can penetrate us. So that should be our seek tonight. Where we seek that secret place. That secret place that transform, bring us into a place where we look like Christ, where we sound like Christ, where we demonstrate Christ in our daily journey. We should seek that place. In that transformed place, as my sister sang that song, we become more aware. We become more aware of God. Because he downloads to us the very things he wants us to know about. The very thing that he wants us to execute in this earth realm. We become more sensitive. We become more alert. Because all of God's attributes, they are working in us. The secret place of God. In that secret place, provision is made. We will be provided. God said in Philippians 4:19, he said, I shall supply all of your needs according to his riches in glory. All of our needs will be supplied if we truly make that secret place our abiding place, where we have that closeness, that intimacy with God, where we are transparent before him. where we are broken before this God. I pray tonight that this will be our seek. Not on things that a secret place will be our seek. There is a scripture said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, and every other things will be added. So when we seek this secret place where we are provided by God, where we are protected by God, where God transforms us, provision is made, we are in a safe place. The safest place we can be is in that secret place. God is willing to protect his people from life storms. Don't be fooled. When the storms come raging, don't allow those storms to have us to lose hope. We must always be reminded of the word of God. In the secret place, God reveals. And sometimes you sit in wondering by faith. We enter into the secret place. To each, a measure is given. And we can only grow in faith when our life becomes the word. It surpassed reading the word, but the very application of the word we will arise in faith. The faith is the keeping power. Faith and obedience is the keeping power for that secret place of the Most High God. Whew. Tonight, they may have some people in here or someone lying, might hearing about this secret place. This secret place, it's only for the godly. But it can be for you if you come to that place to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, cleansing you from all sins and unrighteousness, becoming a part of the family of God, then that secret place will be available to you. So those that name the name of Christ, this life is more than possessions. It's us fulfilling the mandate and the purposes and the will of God in the earth, where the kingdom of God will come and his will be done in and through our life. That's the very purpose. And the secret place will guide us along that way. Tonight, do you trust God's word? That's a question asked to the congregation. Questions we're going to ask. Do we trust God's word? Do we truly trust God's word? How many times God say a thing and we do contrary to what he says? Because in one category, it could be we truly didn't understand. In another person's life, it could be because of fear. Knowing what he said, but fear to step out. Tonight, let these things change. Let there be a change in our walk with God. That when it comes to faith, though Jesus is our perfect example, when it comes to faith, it will be another Abraham that trusted God beyond what his natural eyes could have seen. Let our eyes let our life be like another Paul. When we have experienced the presence of God, we come to a place to never look back. Let that be our life tonight. And do we believe this God is faithful to deliver his promises? Do we believe that? Do we believe God is able to deliver his promises? God said he's not slack concerning it. Do we believe he's able to deliver that? You know, sometimes we portray we believe, but if we truly believed, our life would have been different. And that's the truth. We babble in all kinds of things. We waver in all kinds of things. Unsure, not certain, you know? That's our life. It doesn't matter how God speaks. Is it, Bob? Is it? I can assure you, his word is yea and amen. When God say a thing, trust God in it. He will perform it. When God say a thing, trust him. He will perform it. God has delivered the Israelites. So why we believe God wouldn't deliver us? Why we believe God wouldn't come true for us? Why we believe. So tonight, church, let there be a change in our mind. For the things that we seek. A change in our hearts. For the things that we seek. Let us truly come to a place. The first thing in the morning, God, our priority. In the middays, God, first priority. To sleep at night, let it be God, our priorities. Let us make God the very center of our lives. And see the very things that in front of our very eyes be revealed to us. God is a revealer. Do you believe that tonight?
Amen. Amen.
God is a revealer.
Hallelujah.
God revealed his secrets.
Yes.
To those that fear him.
Yes.
God reveals.
Yes.
God reveals his secret.
Yes, Lord.
So tonight, church,
oh my God,
just let this secret place
yes,
be our home.
Yes.
Let this secret place be our dwelling place. Let this secret place be our residence. Oh my God.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Trans together for the Lord, everybody. Oh my God. One of the things that God is making very clear tonight, that there are storms. There are storms raging in our lives and in situations represented here. I hear that very clear. Thank you, Jerrica. That these storms are raging. And these storms are really causing fear. These storms are really getting all our attention. And as a result of that, we become distracted with the storms, failing, like Jerrica said, to realize that God has a place for us to shelter, that secret place, that hiding place, and God wants to deliver us. While she was speaking, I sense very, very deep in my heart that God wants to turn the lives of everyone in this building. Turn your life around. Everything that is bothering you, everything that is coming your way, God wants to give you the answer, the solution. Let me say this tonight. Tonight, you can walk through this door knowing that you can withstand and weather any storm in the name of Jesus. And, you know, when people surfing, what happens? They look for the highest waves. They don't want another thing. And they wait for those waves and they ride them over. God is saying, surfers here tonight, you've got your surfing boards and you don't even know it. You're not using it. Tonight is the night for your deliverance and for your victory. God wants to do it for you. What a word tonight. Let God work on your behalf. You will ride out every storm. It doesn't matter what it looks like. I want you to come tonight. Everybody, come up. Everybody in this place. Maybe come with your bag because from here you're going to go straight home. Come straight up. Come straight up, straight up, straight up, straight up. Come, we can look at the offering just now. Come straight up, straight up, straight up. Everybody, come. Come. Touch somebody next to you and say, this is all right. God is going to do it. Let him come this way too. Come. Come, wait on the back. Come. It's all right. It's going to be all right. Touch somebody. You're prophesying to them. It's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. Hallelujah. Whether it's a workplace problem, whether it's a bedroom problem, meaning your house, your family, Whatever it is, take your surfing board. That's right. Thank you, dear. And we are going to ride over the storm tonight. Come, those of you at the back, come. See if you can come a little closer. Karabasa karabashiantai. Hallelujah. Doesn't matter what you're going through. It's all right. Did you hear me? It's all right. It's all right. God is in control. It's all right. Touch somebody. Prophesy on them. Say, it's all right. It's all right. It's all right. It's all right. Lift your hands. Play that thing that you queue up there for me, please.
I
Give me the first verse again. Just give me the first verse. Let me say this to you. He's with you tonight. I say he's with you tonight. He's with you tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And we're getting ready. Getting ready to minister. We're 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 getting ready to minister. Oh, shakarabo shekorobo shekorobo diyan.
That I must run.
I have no fear. We're getting ready. Just get ready. Just get ready. Jesus walks beside me. For I'm sheltered in the arms of God. Oh, let the storms rise, the dark clouds rise. They won't worry me, for I'm sheltered within the arms of God. He walks with me, and not alone can harm me. For I'm sheltered. Lift those hands high. Lift those hands. Declare it. The arms of God. The arms of God. That's the secret place, in the arms of God. In the arms of God. Every intimidating factor, every intimidating thing that is driving fear in your life, we defeat this moment in the name of Jesus. And we speak to those storms in your life. Be still. Be still. Be still. Lay hands. Be still. Be still. Be still. Be still. Be still. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Just hold a minute. Hold a minute. Hold hands. Hold hands. There's a corporate anointing. Hold hands. Hold hands. Hold hands. Show this place. Hold hands. You have allowed it to drive you, to push you. You have allowed it to throw you helter-skelter, different places. But tonight we bring an end. Tonight we bring an end. And we declare, come, 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 come. Come, peace, 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 be still, Shakaraba, peace, 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 in the name of Jesus. If you have a word, just release it in the air. Peace, peace, the peace of God that passeth all understanding. Peace. In the name of Jesus. Kurabaka sakaraba shakaraba diantai. Peace. 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 Every troubled water, every strong wind, in the name of Jesus. Every troubled water, every strong wind. Peace. Peace. Peace, be still in the name of Jesus. Peace, 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 be still. Peace, be still. Peace, be still. Peace, be still. Peace, 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 be still. Still in the name of Jesus. Peace. Peace. In the name of Jesus. Peace of God. Peace of God reigns. In the name of Jesus. Peace. 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 Peace of God. Peace. Speak the peace of God. We speak the peace of God. Oh, too much of trouble, 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 trouble. Peace! Problem, problem, problem. Peace! Be still. From today on, we speak it. We speak it. We speak it. In the name of Jesus. Peace! In the name of Jesus. Peace in the name of Jesus. I speak to those storms. Peace, peace, peace. Hallelujah. The peace of God. Shakarabadi antai. Shakarabadi antai. Just prophesy peace. Just prophesy the peace of God. Peace. So ministers to some of those back there. Shaba baboko bobo shikorobo shiantai. You're gonna make it. You're going to 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 make it. Peace. You're going to make it. Every storm, we speak the peace of God in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Just make sure you lay hands on all those at the back too. The peace of God. Don't go back as yet. Stay here. This lady here. All right. Amen. I'm going to pray. Amen. We reverse every course. Every course. I'm going to reverse every course. Amen. Can we just change that to no? I know I can make it. I know I can stand. I don't know if the worship team want to do that. Hallelujah. I know I can make it. I know I can stand. No matter what come my way. Hallelujah. We speak the powers of darkness must be broken now. Now, in the name of Jesus, we cast you out of this life and we lose her into providence. We lose her into destiny. We lose her into your plan and your will. Break! 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 In the name of Jesus. You have no part, no luck in this life. From today on, peace.
I know that I can stand. No matter.
Lift those hands. Lift those hands. Make up my way.
My life is in your hand.
Come on, declare it. Declare it.
But Jesus, I can make it. With him I know I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands.
Come on, lift it, lift your hands.
With you, Jesus, don't have to worry. And don't you be afraid. Joy comes in the morning. Troubles, they don't last away.
You need to open up your mouth and declare.
For there's a friend in Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart broken,
just lift
your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it.
I know that I can stand.
No matter what.
No.
With him I know I can stand.
No matter what.
No matter what may come my way. My life is in your hands. Know that I can make it.
I know if to get you down.
Right now, clear peace to exactly what we did. Say peace, 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 the peace of God in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Fear no more, be intimidated no more. Make a shout unto God, everybody. Make a shout unto God. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of love and of power and of a sound mind. And so tonight, God, we thank you that you have given us faith, God, to move in and to walk in instead of the fear, oh Father. And you said in Hebrews 11:1 that now faith is the assurance, the title deed, the confirmation of things hoped for. It is divine firmly guaranteed, and the evidence of things not seen, the conviction of their reality. Faith comprehends as fact what cannot be experienced in the physical senses. And tonight, God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. And He is the God that we can stand firm in and put our confidence in and trust in. And though the storm may seem to be raging, it has nothing on us, because we were created to ride the highest wave of the storm because of Jesus Christ, who has given us the power to overcome and the power to overtake. And so stand firm and be peace, and be at peace, and stand in the peace that surpasses all understanding. Because though the storm is out there, to us, by faith, the storm is over. Hallelujah. By faith, the storm is over. Hallelujah. By faith, the storm is over.
Is this going to send us home with that same song? The storm.
Hallelujah.
As soon as you're finished. Come on here, Ezzy. Storm is over. Hallelujah. It's declaration after declaration after declaration.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Come on. Hallelujah.
So by faith, by this same faith, by this same faith, without which it is impossible to please God. Tonight, by faith, we don't just believe, but we know that the storm is over. Hallelujah. Lift your hands in the house tonight. Lift your hands in the house tonight. Lift your hands in the house tonight. As we declare this song before we go, that the storm is over.
I was in a tunnel and couldn't see the light. Whenever I looked up, I couldn't see the sky. Sometimes when I'm standing, it seems like I don't walk for miles. My heart could be crying, yet in the middle of a smile. Oh, but when I climbed the hills, I saw the mountain. I hollered help, 'cause I was lost, and I felt the strong wind. And a small voice sing, storm is over.
Storm is over now.
Oh, I can see the sunshine.
Somewhere beyond the clouds.
Hallelujah. I feel heaven.
Heaven is over me.
Hey, come on and set me free. Of my battles, all hope was gone. Downtown in a rush crowd and fell all alone. Hallelujah. Every now and then I felt like I would lose my mind. I've been waiting for years, and still no finish line. Then I climbed the hills and saw the mountain. I holler help tonight. I holler help, 'cause I was lost, and I felt a strong wind. Then a small voice saying, the storm is over.
Storm is over now.
Somebody believe it tonight. I can see the sunshine. Come on, say, I feel heaven, heaven is over me. Come on and set me free. Hey, somehow my beginning step right in, and faith be
suffering. Now I can depend on the voices of a wind. When it says